the very warmest of welcomes to you to the Palo Vesuvio main hall in Ponticelli, the easternmost quarter of the city of Naples, and it is indeed a warm welcome. It's a piping hot summer's day, turning into a very pleasant summer's evening indeed. And the 30th summer Universiade is in full swing here. Gymnasts about to make their way out onto the field of play. This is the penultimate day of artistic gymnastics action here at the multi-sport venue, the Palo Vesuvio. That will do to get things underway. Lilia Akhtymova. Now, this was a really strong vault in qualification. 14.4 for this particular delivery. Can the 22-year-old do it again? Well, she might well get close to it. She's a really high-impact vaulter. She was part of the Russian team that took the gold at the Universiade a couple of years ago in Chinese Taipei. She won the silver medal on the vault there and has enjoyed being the Russian championship medalist in this piece. Easy to see why. She's got very nice technique as a vaulter. Power, but she is well controlled. Huge opportunity for these gymnasts to get a big score early on when starting on vault, and Akhtymova has done that. 14.55. She's gone up by almost a couple of tenths from qualification. Can Hitomi Hatakeda do the same? So the second strongest qualifier has moved up a fraction. Hatakeda, this wasn't as huge a vault, 13.85 in qualifying. And it's good. It's very good indeed. So all of these gymnasts so far have got through the early challenge. The vault has been well delivered. The 18-year-old Hatakeda getting herself absolutely ready. There's a lovely family history of the Universiade in the Hatakeda family. Her mother Yukiko actually competed at it. That's a really good vault, 14.075. Made her international senior debut in the competition yesterday. Very proud moment for her. She put an awful lot of work into getting to that stage too. So here we go, Uliana Perebinosova to get things underway in this second group. Well, that was very well delivered too. 13.65 was her score in qualifying. She just has a little hop back as she comes out of the vault into the landing. Toes are well pointed. 13.5, well executed vault, not a massively high difficulty, very similar to her score in qualification. Akhtymova sets the early pace. Hatakeda, Sugihara, and then Gertz making up the top four. Perebinosova a little way behind, but it's very early days in the process. It's tempting to read an awful lot into the scores at the conclusion of her first rotation, but those of you who've been watching an awful lot of gymnastics over the years will know that there are a lot of stories still to be told in this event.
And even bars, Japan, Hitomi Hatakeda.
Well, she's just won the uneven bars gold at the Japanese Apparatus Championships again. A real breakthrough was in 2017 when she won the gold there. So this is something that has been, over the years, a thoroughly dependable piece of apparatus for her. This is the nice half-turn transition, the Van Leuven. Very elegant looking Jaeger. Very nice routine, very nice routine from Hitomi Hatakeda. One always expects wonderful things on the uneven bars from her. And she's just shown why that expectation is there. Just the briefest of high fives to, probably a low five really, to Jana Vedorova, who's about to compete. Let's look back and enjoy this excellent work from the team gold medalist in the competition yesterday. Team. 13.8 is the score for Hadakeda. So she's only down by half a tenth from the mark in qualifying.
Russia, Uliana Peribinozova. Bim, Chinese Taipei, Ko Ching Fang.
To Uliana Peribinozova, Russian gymnast who does excel on this piece, and that's why, because there's real difficulty to her work. She got a 13.6 in qualifying. It's complex work, it's exciting work, it's well-executed work from Uliana Peribinozova. She made her big senior debut at the European Championships last year, won the team gold there, came fifth in the uneven bars. So once we get to the conclusion of this first half of the split rotation, it'll then be time for another warm-up. The next slot will take to the bars. That's a big jump up. 14.35 from a 13.6 in qualification. Peribinozova really in contention with that display. That's one of the biggest jumps that we've seen so far in that top group. May indeed even be the biggest that we've seen. Now, a look at some earlier work, Lilia Akhaimova. Completes the punch, yeah, well. Very nice dismount, very secure from Lilia Akhaimova. She had a 12.95 for that in qualifying. And this is the gymnast who was leading the way after the first rotation. Coming in as the second strongest qualifier, Akhaimova with a score of 13.1. So she's managed to gain a little bit. Across both of her routines, she has gained something. That takes us to the halfway mark of this rotation. Hadakeda in the lead, Peribinozova second place, very, very close indeed. Just over 200th the gap, then Akhaimova. It really is very tight at the moment. Fedorova is well positioned too. And a little bit of daylight starting to emerge between Mori and Leinonen, but we still have got the second half of this second rotation to come. Be interesting when we get to that halfway mark in a short while to see exactly how it's all looking at the top. It was expected to be close. It certainly is. It is a close competition, and we will now look at the leader, Hitomi Hadakeda. This is a lead of just 2.5 hundredths. She's got 13.1 Hadakeda in qualification. Herself so nicely into that sequence. Didn't take too long to do it either. That's something the judges do watch for. There was a wonderful sense of fluidity to that routine from Hadakeda. And a magnificent reaction upon its conclusion. This was worthy of a big reaction too. The kind of performance at this stage of the competition that can make the difference between winning an all-around event and not.
Floor.
So the score is 13. It is a touch down from qualifying, just by a tenth. Juliana Perovinosova is on the beam. Gymnast who was in second place coming into this rotation. 12.85, she scored on the beam. Oh, goodness, what happened there? Looked as though she'd actually got through that moment. Now, it's just become a little bit problematic. Now then, what might that do to the leaderboard? Juliana Perovinosova, the hands going down on the beam. Quite extraordinary that moment. But ended up solidifying the routine with a good dismount. How much has she lost? She managed to keep it to within a mark. Well, she has done. It's 12.1 for Perovinosova. Now then, this is a great opportunity for Lilia Akhaimova. Just to give a little bit of synopsis, Sugihara has come off. Perovinosova put the hands down. No issues from Hadakeda. So, Akhaimova, who was in second position coming into this rotation, if she stays on and has a secure routine, floor, suddenly she's Finland, wonderfully positioned. She has got a strong floor routine as well to go on to. Well then, Lilia Akhaimova, who took the team silver medal in yesterday's competition, is mounting a very good challenge for gold and doing it in a way that really embodies the spirit of FISU. That reaction between the gymnasts from opposing nations in this particular competition was a real delight to see. We'll see Nabieva in action in some of the apparatus finals. 12.75 for Akhaimova. She's picked up 0.45 from qualification, and as a result, she's really put herself in touching distance, especially. So that is how things stand as we move into the final rotation of this women's all-around artistic gymnastics competition. Juliana Perovinosova sport is a wonderfully dramatic and diverse thing. That's the great joy of these multi-sport games like the Universiade. It's that incredible combination of athletic ability with the storytelling. It all just adds to the sense of drama that I'm sure you're feeling watching at home. Now, has Perubinosova done enough to go ahead of Mori? She certainly has. 12.75 is the score for Perubinosova. Now, here we go. Lilia Akhaimova. 13.35 for this routine in qualification. It's very, very strong if all goes well. The shock, the audible gasp as the hands went down. And what does that mean now for Lilia Akhaimova's chances of securing this gold medal? It only just takes one small moment. It is the cruelest of things, a gymnastics competition, and there it was. And it's 12.3 for Lilia Akhaimova. And that means she is positioned in second place. Perubinosova holding on to the lead. But what now for Hitomi Adekeda? Surely she'll be able to do this. It seems a mere formality now for Hitomi Adekeda to wait for the score to come in. And she basks just for a moment in the applause of the crowd. And I'm sure the words of the coach there will be, you know what, I think you've done it. I think you're about to get your second gold medal. You have two gymnasts on 52.7. Uliana Perubinosova and Lilia Akhaimova. By virtue of the separation criteria, which is looking at the top three scores of those gymnasts, Perubinosova has it 40.6 to 40.4. We'll come back to that in a moment. Very, very close for Akhimova. Hasn't quite made it into the silver medal position. Surely Adakeda is about to fly into the gold medal position. And indeed she is. She points to the flag on her arm, the Hinomaru. It is another gold for Japan. They are in total control of artistic gymnastics here at Napoli 2019. It's a clean sweep so far. And one that has been triumphed by Hitomi Hadakeda, with Uliana Perebinosova taking the silver medal. Great display by Perebinosova. She really did deliver a fantastic uneven bars routine. That 14.35 on the uneven bars of paramount importance to her in securing that silver over her teammate Lilia Akhimova.
Ladies and gentlemen, and now please rise for the International University Sports Federation Anthem. E ora, signore e signori, per favore in piedi per l'inno della Federazione Internazionale Sport. Thank you, Mr. Schick and Mr. Pitton. Vi ricordiamo l'appuntamento di domani per le finali di specialità.
And there they are, the medalists in the women's all-around competition in artistic gymnastics at Napoli 2019.